In 1983, two dedicated young filmmakers gleaned the talents of many amateur actors and artists to create the impossible. A full-length motion picture titled The Big Hurt, produced entirely in a brand new format called home video, the first of its kind. The Big Hurt was made, premiered, awarded, and all but forgotten. Nearly 40 years later, like the phoenix rising from the ashes of its past, The Big Hurt is ready for the 21st century. Digitally remastered and enhanced, re-edited, reimagined, and reconceived for a stimulating movie experience you'll not likely forget. Master storyteller Stefan Welch and Gary Kaiser present The Big Hurt, Definitive Director's Edition.
This is a tragic love story, with ill-fated lovers, wild adventures, and murder. And it all started with a burglary.
Thank you.
gunsmith, a man wrestling with complex obsessions while fighting inner demons from his past and hiding a deadly secret.
Please, let me have your attention. Come on, you guys. Now that's more like it.
I don't care. As far as I'm concerned, you've had too much time already. What do you mean, more money? What did you do with the last check I gave you? Don't talk to me like that, you little creep. I'm Getty Money's Worth, the richest man in the world. And I have controlling interest in every major corporation in this country, not to mention Sony and Volvo. I own Rhode Island, for God's sakes. Okay, but this is the last one. I want this thing taken care of. Yes. All right, fine. Goodbye.
Excuse me, Mr. Bodecker, you
want
to see me?
Jim, have a seat.
John.
What I have to tell you is very difficult for me to say.
Well, sir, I would suggest you just come right out and say it.
Here at the school, we feel that it's best that we terminate you.
I'm fired? But why?
You don't have to thank me.
I have a contract.
Here it is.
Oh, no! Oh!
John! When are you ever going to make something of yourself? I'm tired of asking you. Clean up your room. Make something of yourself. All you ever think about, girls and music. Girls and music. And those girls you love. Terrible. Terrible.
This is Melanie Mundane, a curious investigative reporter who is about to enter a violent and dangerous world that is way beyond her comprehension.
Hey, Bill, I've got something here that looks like a great story.
Every time you come in here, you've got a great story.
No, it's an award winner. I know it is.
Sure.
I mean it this time. This is dynamite stuff. Pure TNT.
Let's see. The last really big story you had, you thought you uncovered the head of the Black Panthers doing business with the mayor, and it turns out to be his pool man. And the time before that, you thought you uncovered the big drug connection on the west side, and he's a representative from Upjohn. Come on, stick to reporting consumer tips and stray dogs.
Oh, damn it, Bill. How am I supposed to get ahead in my career if you keep sticking me with these stupid dog stories? Would you just look what happened to me the other day? The last good, hard news story this station had was that expose on Girl Scout corruption. Bill, if you would just look at this, I know you won't regret it. You won't.
Okay, I'll look at it.
Oh, you're a honey. Thanks.
I'm not promising anything.
Okay. Well, what do you think of Friday? Well, do you know where you want to go? Yeah. What'd he say?
Well, he said he'd take a look at it.
I guess that's the end of that.
No, he's going to take a look at it, and he's going to be screaming for me any minute.
He's got to look at it first.
He will.
Mundane, get in here.
Right away, Bill. Good thing you're not a betting man.
I guess it is.
Doctor.
Yeah, Chief.
Have those affidavits been signed yet?
Signed and processed, Chief.
Well, where are they?
Oh, right here, Chief.
Uh-huh. Very good. Send in Punch and Judy.
That's Jude and Punchley.
I don't care if it's Laurel and Hardy. Just get them in here.
They're not at the station right now, Chief. They're still on the last case that you sent them on.
What was that?
Corruption in the Girl Scouts.
All right, let's go. Come on, sweetheart. Over there.
Move it, you bum.
Blow it out your ass, you f***ing piece of pig shit.
Heard it all before. Let's go.
What do you need, Chief?
Murder. Does that mean anything to you, Jude?
Well, I am a homicide detective.
Punchley?
Murder. Noun. Gothic origin. The act of unlawfully killing a human being by another human being with premeditated malice.
That's exactly right. And that's why we're here. Lately, there has been a rash of brutal murders in and about our fair city. And I have an idea that they are all the result of one odious persona.
What makes you think he smells, Chief?
Odious, adjective.
Shut up. Slang. Now, the reason that I think that it is the same felon is because of certain pieces of evidence. Beside every victim, we found this burned dollar bill. And this. This looks to me like the work of... I almost hate to say it.
Go ahead and say it, Chief.
A psychotic Nazi!
What makes you say that, Chief?
Well, here's a fresh one. Just came in a half hour ago. He was a high school principal named Bodecker. He was beaten to a bloody pulp, thrown out a window, run over by a 71 Pontiac, beheaded, and stabbed 43 and a half times.
The same clues, Chief?
Exactly the same. Killer is a male Caucasian, 6 feet tall, brown hair, blue eyes, about 265 pounds. No facial markings, big toe missing on his left foot. He graduated from Northwestern University with a B.S. in musical psychology. He's 45 years old, lives right here in the city. Oh yes, his name's John Smith.
Not much to go on, Chief.
We do know this. He was a music teacher at the high school and Bodecker just fired him.
That gives us a motive, for this one at least.
I've been thinking diligently about this, about who to assign to this case. And I thought, how about you two?
I can't think of anyone either, Chief.
I've got it!
What?
What about us, Chief?
Why didn't I think of that?
Probably common sense, Chief.
Now listen, the most important thing in this case is to keep it quiet. We don't want panic in the streets. The worst thing that could happen to this case is that the media could get hold of this.
This story is fantastic, Melanie. I gotta hand it to you. You were right this time. Are you sure these facts are correct?
Absolutely. I got all my information from my source at the coroner's office.
Are you positive no other station has this story?
Not until 11 o'clock tonight when they tune in to our lead story, which I'm going to deliver.
Well, you've earned it. Now get out of here and write your copy.
I really appreciate this, Bill.
Ambition and hard work should be rewarded. I owe you a dinner, too. Remind me.
I'd rather remind you to give me a raise.
Muhammad Schwartz, have a seat.
Thank you.
Now, I've been looking over your resume and application. And I'm sorry to say there are no openings for a music teacher at this time.
Are you sure?
I'm gonna level with you, Smith. You don't have any qualifications for the positions available. You don't have any references. You don't have any skills. You don't have any knowledge. You don't have any charisma. You don't have any personality. Your suit's wrinkled. Your shirt doesn't fit. You got bad breath. You're bald. You're just a mess, man.
What are you, nothing? You're really nothing? Who do you think you are? Your father and I tried. We tried so hard, John. But what are you? You ain't nothing but an asshole.
You're taking this much too personally, Smith.
Shut up! I want the information.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Don't play games with me! Perhaps a little persuasion is necessary.
It would be a shame to waste this young man's potential investment career.
Dad!
You're bluffing.
Is your tongue loosening up yet?
You won't get a thing out of me. I was captured by the Viet Cong.
Her machismo, eh?
Wait, what are you doing? Give that back.
Very interesting.
Look, wait. You win. Okay, you win. I'll do anything you want. I'll tell you anything you want to know. I'll get your job. You can have my job.
Too late, infidel.
After succumbing to his basic instincts, completely demoralized and ashamed, John Smith ventures out into the world, alone, broken, hunted, searching for that small piece of normalcy.
Hello.
What can I get you to drink?
Oh, a fine Bavarian lager would be nice.
A what?
Give me Stroh's.
Gotcha. That'll be a buck.
Oh. Here, keep the change.
Gee, thanks.
See, who's that girl down there in the bar?
What should I know? I just work here. I mind my own business. But listen.
Set her up with another drink. I'll take care of the rest.
Sure.
Hi, my name's John.
My name's Felicia. Felicia Flowers. I'm from New York originally, and I just moved out here a couple years ago. How about you? You live here? Of course you live here. You sound like you live here. Everybody out here has an accent. They all tack funny out here. What are you drinking? Beer. Yeah. This is a whiskey. If you feel like it, you can buy me another one, you know. Well, I'll tell you what. It's been a real slow day, and I haven't had much business, so, how about you and I go to bed together?
Golly, that was fun.
Yeah. Next time you think you might not giggle so much?
I'm sorry, it's just that I'm ticklish. It
makes you think it'll be a next time.
What the hell's that supposed to mean?
You think I'm loose or something? Maybe cheap. I'm not easy.
Ha! You are the easiest guy this week. Don't flatter yourself. You're not Burt Reynolds, you know. You're not Clint Eastwood. I mean, you really disgust me. Just look at yourself. Your nose hairs need trimming. Your toenails need trimming. Probably some kind of wimpy mama's boy. I mean, still live at home? Huh? Still hanging on to mama's apron strings? I'm not sitting here with you anymore. God, you make me pretty sick, you know?
You're sitting out of crack nice. Terrible! Why can't you ever be like your father? Now, your father was something. He made something of himself. But you, you. I tell you, John, sometimes I'm so ashamed of you. I'm really ashamed. Do something for yourself. Make something out of your mind.
And now, all the news that's worth reporting in the metropolitan area with Roger Turk, John Sullivan, and Melanie Mundane. This is WDS9 Superstation News.
This is Melanie Mundane at police headquarters, where an intense investigation is being conducted into the many murders that have occurred in our city recently. So far, there are no leads to the killer's identity. Officials do state, however, that all of these crimes have been committed by the same man. Here comes Chief of Police Harry Broadside. Chief Broadside, could you please tell us a little more about these murders and what is being done to put a stop to them?
Well, there have been 7 murders to date, and I have 2 of my best homicide detectives on the case.
Could you please tell
us
if
there's... That's all I can tell you at this time. Except that we're hot on the killer's trail, and we expect to have him in custody very soon. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have some police work to do.
Thank you, Chief Broadside.
Can you give us any more information?
And with us now are homicide detectives Punch and Judy. That's Jude and Punch.
Are you two through being TV celebrities? Ready to be homicide detectives again?
You seem upset, Chief.
You're damn right I'm upset. I've got 7 murders in the last 8 weeks. I have sketchy evidence. I have 2 inept buffoons working on the case. Why shouldn't I be upset? Been to that employment agency?
No, Chief. We already have jobs.
What about the bar where that Flowers woman was last seen alive?
No, Chief.
And why not?
Well, Chief, I prefer a place with a big dance floor and a live band.
No. I mean to question anyone who might have seen the killer.
Hey, great suggestion, Chief.
Now you two listen to me, and you listen close. I want this mystery killer, John Smith, apprehended within 48 hours, or else the 2 of you will be out looking for jobs. You got that?
Yeah, Chief.
Good. Now that we understand one another, let's move out.
On assignment. These 2 crime fighters are hurtling toward unimaginable danger.
We're here about the Felicia Flowers killing.
Was she a regular customer?
No, I don't think I've ever seen her in here before.
Do you remember her leaving here with anyone?
Thanks a lot.
Bye, John. Let me think. Seems to me like she did leave here with a guy by the name of John Smith. He was a strange sort of guy. He paid me with dollar bills with burnt corners.
Hey, Carol,
and the murderers, Detective. We are hot on his trail at the present time and anticipate his apprehension shortly. Detective, you will let us know of any progress. Absolutely. Thank you. This has been Melanie Mundane with a live minicam on Superstation WDS9.
Song every time we chase someone.
This is Melanie Mundane with police detectives in hot pursuit of a wanted murderer, a WDS9 exclusive report.
See this? You know what this is?
But she...
Shut up! Don't say anything. I'll tell you what this is. This is a damage report from the little adventure you two had yesterday. Jesus Christ, it's endless. I'm surprised you two didn't drive into the mayor's nude swimming pool. How could I have been so stupid as to assign you two buffoons to this case?
I can assure you, Chief, that we are working feverishly to find out the address of our killer.
Don't waste your time, damn it! I already have his address.
But, Chief, how did you get it?
I looked in the phone book.
Hey, great piece of police work, Chief.
Never mind that. Just go to this address and you'll find your killer. Now get out of my sight.
The strength of local, state, and federal forces converge upon a foe. Unbeknownst to them, of inconceivable ability and impenetrable power.
John, did you see your roof this morning? What a mess! It's terrible! What are you having on the street now? Your father and I will give you every opportunity, and you never try! You never try at all! You're a big us, John, and we're ashamed of you. We're really ashamed of you.
I'm sorry I wasn't perfect, Mother. I'm sorry.
Thank you. Come on!
Headquarters, where inside Detective Alice Jude is ceremoniously being promoted to captain. As you may recall, Detective Jude was very instrumental in putting an end to the many murders that plagued our city 1 year ago. Detective Jude is the first woman in our city's history to become captain. This is all a part of our mayor's new equality policy instigated last election day.
Have a seat, Captain. Would you like a cup of coffee?
Yes, sir, I would. Thank you.
Proctor, bring some coffee. First, let me congratulate you on your promotion.
Thank you, sir.
Oh, don't thank me. I had nothing to do with it. If it had been up to me, you never would have got the promotion. You'd be out walking the streets on a beat. But the mayor wanted a woman for the job. So, you got it. He picked you. And now you're a captain. And your first official act will be to head the investigation into the theft of the Star of Moscow Diamond.
But the Star of Moscow Diamond has been missing for a year. It could be anywhere in the world by now.
Exactly. And your job is to find out where that anywhere is. The Russian embassy is in an uproar. The UN is afraid of an international incident. The commissioner is not happy. So I suggest that if you want to keep your rank, you get results quick. You understand that, Captain?
Yes, sir.
Good. Then get to it.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, let me speak to him. Mr. Moneysworth, I did everything you asked. I expect results very soon. Huh? Yes, sir. Nothing can go wrong this time. Oh. Yes, sir. RL SWAT.
Punchley!
Hi.
Punchley, I thought you were dead.
Well, no, actually, I'm alive. See, I can move all my parts.
But I saw you get shot in the head. I read your name in the obituaries.
You didn't come to my funeral?
No, I couldn't. I had a date.
I see.
So tell me, how did you survive?
Well, I've been working two, sometimes three jobs, mowing lawns.
No, I meant the gunshot wound.
Oh, that.
Ah, yes, well, good fortune shined its light upon me that morning because there was a full moon the night before and a southeasterly wind. The trajectory of the bullet went slightly off to the left, grazing me on the side of the head, knocking me unconscious. I didn't wake up till they threw dirt in my face. Scared the hell out of those gravediggers, let me tell you.
Wow, that is just amazing.
Hey, I heard you promoted to captain. Congratulations.
Thanks. Can you believe it? Me, a captain.
Yeah, I always thought you were the best man for the job. Sorry.
Listen, I'm in a hurry. The chief assigned me to that Star of Moscow diamond case, and I want to make a good impression.
Well, hey, good luck.
Thanks. You take care of yourself, okay?
Okay.
I hope I see you again soon.
You do?
Sure. You were the best partner I ever had. We made a good team.
Young man, would you help me with my groceries?
Yes, ma'am.
Got to get out of this town.
Where are you going?
Any place but here. Maybe I'll go to the country. Would you come with me?
Me? Why me?
I have a confession to make, Jude.
Please, call me Alice.
I have a confession to make, Alice.
What?
All that time you were chasing me, I wanted you to catch me.
Why?
Because I love you, that's why. You're all I've thought about this past year, and I'm asking you to come with me.
But I can't. I've just been promoted to captain with a major assignment, 7 boyfriends, and my dry cleaning is due next Saturday. I can't leave all that behind.
Sure you can. Where's your sense of adventure? Where's your sense of fun? Where's your sense of love?
What?
Where's your sense of hearing? Listen, I'm offering you a new life without the routine and boredom. I'm offering you affection, companionship, and love.
Let's go.
Our two lovers, propelled into the tumultuous vortex of unabashed eroticism, where cunning and guile are their only weapons.
So, are you through with this Nazi nonsense?
Oh, yeah. I found this real great psychiatrist who told me I hated my mother and had a great desire to know my father.
You never knew your father?
No. He died when I was 2 years old. But I heard he was an extraordinary man. Deeply religious and just full of life.
What happened to him?
He was run over by a church bus.
Oh, how awful.
What about you folks, Jude? They still have this earth?
No, under it.
Oh, I see. You know, Alice, you, we have a lot in common. I think we were made for each other.
Mother of God. Is this accurate?
Absolutely.
Are you sure?
Sullivan just called me. He saw everything. He's very reliable.
It's unbelievable. Smith and Punchley alive? And Jude ran away with Smith? Are you sure she wasn't kidnapped?
Sullivan said there was no sign of any force being used whatsoever.
What about that red-headed woman? Who is she?
No idea. The computer's trying to track her down right now.
Christ, what a mess. The commissioner's not going to like this one bit.
No, sir.
Listen, I want you to get two men and get on their trail.
Right away, Chief.
Money's worth here.
Mr. Moneysworth, I have some bad news.
Holy Jesus, Mother of God. Now you get this straight. You better take care of the situation or I'll take care of it. And if I take care of it, I'll take care of you too. Now get me that diamond.
Vladimir Komsky reporting as requested, sir.
Comrade Komsky, I have a very important mission for you. It is top secret for security reasons.
What is the mission, sir?
This is the Star of Moscow Diamond. Are you familiar with it?
Yes, sir. It is one of the homeland's most prized treasures. Ruthlessly stolen last year and never seen again.
That is correct. Your mission, should you choose to accept it, is to find the Star of Moscow and to return it so that it may once again be a glorious national treasure. Do you understand, comrade?
Yes, sir, but...
But what, comrade Komsky?
But, sir, I wouldn't even know where to begin to look.
Well, perhaps we can help you. Look at these people. That man is John Smith. He is a fugitive, formerly believed to be dead, wanted in connection with a series of many brutal murders. He is now traveling with that woman, Alice Jude, a former homicide detective who was recently promoted to captain. That man's name is Punchley.
Punchley?
That's correct. We have very little information concerning this man. All we know is that he was also once a homicide detective, a partner with the Jude woman. He was believed to be killed by John Smith, and now he is in pursuit of the two of them, presumably for revenge. He was last seen picking up that woman who was hitchhiking. We have been unable to identify her as yet, but they are now all traveling across this country. Find them and you will find the Star of Moscow. Good luck, comrade. And may the spirit of our beloved Lenin and Marx go with you.
Thank you, sir, for this opportunity to prove my worthiness to you.
Not to worry, kid.
My
name's Punchley.
Punchley?
Yeah, that's right. What's your name?
Frederica. Frederica Flowers.
Frederica Flowers? That name sounds familiar.
Oh, well, maybe you've read some of my books.
Oh, you're an author.
Uh-huh.
Well, that's fascinating. What sort of things do you write about?
Contemporary religious texts, mostly. My latest one is Nukes for Christ. Have you heard of it?
Nukes for Christ. No, I can't say that I have, but I would like to read it.
Oh, well, you can have this copy if you want. It's autographed and everything.
Oh, gee, thanks. I've never met an author before. How'd you get in that line of work?
For as long as I can remember, I always wanted to be a writer. When I was a teenager, my parents ran off. I never did understand why. Anyway, my sister and I, we were left to fend for ourselves. She went to work so that I could go to college.
Hey, what's the matter? Gosh, I hope it wasn't anything I said. What is it? Please tell me.
About a year ago, my sister was brutally murdered.
Oh, God. Her name was Felicia, wasn't it?
Yes, it was, but how did you know?
I know all about it, Frederica. I used to be a homicide detective assigned to that case.
You were?
Yeah, I personally tracked down her killer and shot him.
Oh, Punchley, I'm so proud of you. But he's not dead, he's still on the loose, isn't he?
Yeah.
I knew it. I had a vision. The Lord came to me, and he said that the name of the killer was John Smith, and that he was still alive.
God told you his name was John Smith.
Well, no, I heard that on the news. But he did tell me to avenge the death of my sister. Avenge. Avenge.
Oh, I see.
I'm on a sacred mission. When I find that creep, I'm gonna blow his head off.
I'd like to help you. I was hot on his trail when I picked you up. I think he's kidnapped a good friend of mine, and I've got to rescue her.
That's great. That's great. I think we'll make a good team. I'd hate to have to do this alone. Loneliness is the worst thing in the world. Believe me, I know. I've been alone since my sister was killed. Punchley, I could use a good friend.
I'd like to be your friend.
I'm glad. But before we go any further, I think we should have a plan. What's wrong with the car, Punchley?
Car. Always acting up.
Oh, good heaven. How much further? Can we make it down there?
The name?
Mr. and Mrs. Punchley.
Punchley?
That's right.
Doctor?
Hi, Chief.
I really wish you wouldn't do that.
Sorry, Chief.
I want all of last week's arrest reports.
I've got them right here. I took the liberty of... Chief Broadside's office. Yes, sir. Right away, sir.
Who the hell was that?
The commissioner.
Commissioner Oz?
Is there any other?
What did he want?
He wants to see us right away.
Oh, what am I going to do? I can't see the commissioner looking like this.
Oh, Chief, you always look like that.
Oh, God, why did I pick today to wear my Kmart suit?
Now, that's the last word. We're going.
No, no, you go alone. Tell him that I've got the flu and I'm very contagious.
Now, you know I'm not a very good liar. We're going. Stop being such a baby.
I'm the chief of police.
No,
you're my assistant.
Don't make a scene.
I'm supposed to be the one that sets the rules. You're supposed to follow them.
We're gonna have to get it together by the time we get there.
Oz doesn't even like you anyway,
just
much less me.
Just settle down and compose yourself.
Don't tell me to compose myself.
We're gonna be safe.
The man's gonna have me for lunch.
You look fine. Just drink.
No, I don't look fine. Jesus. Why did I wear this suit?
You're working yourself up.
Oh, come on, Proctor.
Now we're almost there.
There's still time. You can tell him I got the flu.
Would you please try to settle
down? Proctor, please. I'm going to cut my wrists. I swear to God, I will.
Give me that thing, Chief.
Thanks. I needed that.
Come forward. I am Oz, the great and powerful. Who are you?
I am Proctor, the thin, and it's me.
Silence, whippersnapper! Chief Broadside.
Yes, your commissioner-ness?
You pitiful, disgusting, obese relic of crippled conniving ineptitude.
There's no need to get personal.
Silence! You have bungled the Star of Moscow Diamond case miserably, and if you do not resolve it, you will face the consequences. Bring me the head of John Smith, and I will grant you your lifelong wish.
That would mean...
Silence! Bring me his head on a silver platter, and I will see that you have the power to walk.
Oh, gee! Thanks, Commissioner!
Silence! You have your orders. Now go.
Don't give me the chance. I mean, it's not that I don't know the technique. I've seen lots of movies. It's just that I never have the opportunity. I came close once. I remember asking this girl in my class if she would go to bed with me. But she was into oral contraception. She said no. It's really tough to find the right person, you know. I mean, there has to be mutual understanding, respect, and love. And now look at me. I'm in a motel room with a beautiful, intelligent, Christian woman. Now I think I'm in love. I mean, I know I'm in love. I was only in love once before, and that was this morning when I saw Alice. Oh, but I'm willing to forget all about her and devote my mind and body to you, if that's what you want. I knew it. I knew you had some feelings for me. I also know that if I'm really careful, I'll be be able to sleep on top of you all night. My hands exploring all your pleasure spots. I'll try not to wake you. Honey, I'm sorry I missed dinner, but I had to work late. All the I Love Lucy reruns didn't come in, and everyone's bowels are in an uproar. No, I'm leaving right now. Okay, Lorraine. Bye-bye.
Bill, I got a story for you.
Oh, no.
I'm serious. You're gonna love it.
I'm sure I will, but can't I love it in the morning?
No, it's too good. I think we should put it on the air right away.
Wait a minute. We're not putting anything on the air that's supposed to go on.
Bill, you can't ignore this story.
Watch me.
I'm not gonna let you leave this office until you read what I've got here.
Melanie, it's hot. I'm tired. I've been here all day. I wanna go home, all right?
Fine. If you leave, then I'll call your wife and tell her we're having an affair.
Ah, she'd love it. She thinks I need more exercise.
Come on, Bill, please.
No.
Fine, I'll call your wife and tell her you're having an affair with a man.
You wouldn't.
Just watch me.
Give me that. Say what?
It's all been confirmed and verified.
We gotta get this on the air right away.
We interrupt the scheduled transmission to bring you a special news bulletin.
This is Melanie Mundane at police headquarters, where we have learned that newly appointed Captain Alice Jude has relinquished her position in the department by fleeing the city with wanted fugitive John Smith. Smith is being sought by police in connection with many murders and the disappearance of the star of Moscow Diamond. Also implicated in this incident are Chief of Police Harry Broadside and multi-trillionaire Getty Moneysworth. I will be bringing you further updates as more information is available. This has been Melanie Mundane with Superstation WDS9 returning.
Hello, Mr. Moneysworth. I'm sorry to call you at this late hour. The situation's become critical. Look, the commissioner has involved himself personally in the case, and he's been all over my butt. If he investigates any closer, he's going to find out about our business arrangement. We'll all go to jail. And on top of everything else, some nosy TV reporter's been blabbing the story all over the tube.
Because of your incompetence, I'm afraid to say that I must effect some drastic measures. As far as our business arrangement is concerned, you may consider it terminated. Hector, this is your boss. I know it's late. I have something for you to do. Get me the mallet.
Why didn't you tell me he was following us?
I didn't know.
How could you not know?
Well, excuse me. Kill me, why don't you?
I've thought about it, believe me. Is he still behind us?
No, I think you lost him. So what do we do now?
We gotta get out of this place, that's for sure. I'll try to find a job someplace. We're gonna need money soon.
I'm very glad to see you, my dear friend. How are you? All right, why don't we just get down to business then?
Why don't we?
This is the Star of Moscow diamond, and these are the people necessary to locate in order to obtain the diamond, along with complete instructions.
Instructions have been understood and evaluated. A course of action has already been plotted.
Good, good. I guess that completes our business for today.
Not quite.
What is it?
The money.
Ah, yes. Can I write you a check? I didn't think so.
Look, I haven't got time to talk. Why don't you just go away?
I think you would find it in your best interest to talk to me.
Look, I don't know who you are, but I know I don't like you. Who the hell are you?
I'm Vladimir Komsky on special assignment for the Soviet embassy, and I am looking for these people.
You're a commie. Will you just haul your red commie ass out of here? Let me go, you pinko creep. You won't get anything out of me. They left early this morning, heading west on Route 32. They're in a Plymouth convertible and an orange Volkswagen. God.
Thanks.
Yes, Cindy, you won't believe what was in here. A commie, a red, a maniac from Moscow.
Cindy Rosenblum, FBI. I'd like you to answer some questions.
FBI? Sure, I'll answer some questions.
Have you ever seen these people?
Sure, they stayed here last night.
When did they leave?
They left early this morning, heading west on Route 32. They were in a Plymouth convertible in an orange Volkswagen, and they stayed in rooms 9 and 10.
Thank you.
Sidney Rosenblum, an experienced and confident FBI agent, who is about to be outsmarted by his own common sense, not to mention those god-awful clones.
Hi. Gladys Work, CIA.
Yeah, they left early this morning, heading west on Route 32 in a Plymouth convertible and an orange Volkswagen. And they stayed in rooms 9 and 10.
Well, thank you.
You're welcome.
Gladys Works, an inexperienced but ambitious young CIA agent, trained to use her feminine wiles to infiltrate even the hardest of hearts, on the fast track to her destiny.
All right, up against the wall. Feet back and spread them.
Watch it.
Sorry. Now, let's see who we've got here. Gladys Works, CIA. You're with the CIA?
That's right. I'll feet back, spread them.
Well, you say that as if you mean it.
Get it up there. Now let's see who you are. Sidney Rosenblum, FBI. You're with the FBI?
That's right, sweetheart.
Well, you don't look like an FBI agent to me.
Let me say, you're the prettiest CIA agent I've ever seen.
Oh, really?
Where are you?
They left early this morning, headed west on Route 32. They're in a Plymouth convertible and an orange Volkswagen. And they stayed in room 910.
Thanks.
Thank you.
here.
Melanie Mundane here with the Superstation WDS9 exclusive report. In our investigation to find wanted murderer John Smith, we have come to this small motel. I am now talking with the owner and manager of this establishment, Mrs. Excuse me, ma'am. Could you please tell me your name? All right, I understand you wanting to remain anonymous, but could you please tell us if there have been any suspicious characters at your motel within the last 24 hours? Excuse me, ma'am. Could you please... I'm sorry, ma'am. I didn't hear you. For you people at home, it has become clear to this reporter that this woman is mute and unable to communicate verbally. However, she is writing it down, and you are seeing it exclusively on Superstation WDS9. They left early this morning, heading west on Route 32 in a Plymouth convertible and an orange Volkswagen. They stayed in rooms... Thanks. Melanie Mundane here, Superstation WDS9. This is Melanie Mundane here with another in a series of exclusive reports on Superstation WDS9. I am now talking with agents of the CIA and FBI who are investigating John Smith and his involvement with the Star of Moscow Diamond. Could you please tell us how this investigation is going?
I'm very pleased with the way things are going. Yes, that's absolutely wonderful. No, your instructions need no modifications. Proceed with the plan as discussed. Ah, yes, thank you. Goodbye.
Oh, joy.
Jobs in here that I'd be interested in.
Great. Let me see. Yeah, this is excellent. Tell you what, why don't I take you to breakfast tomorrow? And yeah, we can both check out some of these jobs.
Sounds like a wonderful idea. You know, since I've been with you, I've never been so happy.
Really?
Yeah. This is the first time I've ever felt so independent, so free. All my life I've had to answer to someone or be responsible for somebody. My mother was a real bitch, let me tell you. I'm sure you know what I'm talking about.
Oh, yeah.
Well, she made sure my childhood was miserable. I had to do all the work around the house as well as take care of my younger brothers and sisters. And if I messed up, she was right there to let me know. My father was no help. He crawled inside of a whiskey bottle in 1965 and only came out 3 times a year to pay the taxes. And that's why I joined the police force, so I could take charge of my life. That didn't work out, as you know. I was a lousy cop. The only reason I was promoted was because I was a woman. I know that, but I don't care. But when I'm with you, things are so different, and I'm happy. So very, very happy.
Anything interesting in the paper?
Nah, not really. A few shootings, a couple stabbings. Wino got set on fire. Oh yeah, the foot got cut with a 14-year-old.
Hmm. Don't you think we ought to get going?
We got plenty of time.
They can't be too far away.
Waited on. This is getting ridiculous.
I'm sure a waitress will be along any minute now.
We've been waiting a long time.
We're busy this morning. Don't worry about it. What's your hurry?
There's no hurry. It's just that when I walk into a restaurant, I'm accustomed to being waited on promptly. Don't tell me to take it easy. Don't tell me what to do. God is my witness. I'll never be hungry again. If I have to lie, cheat, or kill, as God is my witness, I'll never be hungry again.
Hey, turn on Channel 9. The semifinals of the World Egg Fighting Championships are on.
Celebrating the momentum of human endeavor. Grasping at the essence of athletic endurance. And celebrating all that we know as the mild world of sports. And now, here's Gib Gifford.
Hi, this is Gib Gifford, live from Superstation WDS9 in the mild world of sports with the semifinals of the World Egg Fighting Championship. We're here at the lovely Egg World Restaurant today, live in front of a capacity crowd to witness the New York Yokes against the Cincinnati Shells. Boy, I'll tell you, it looks like the action's really getting thick out there. Somebody from the Cincinnati team is down on a slip there, and the ref has just blown the whistle on another double yoking foul, and I mean to tell you, we've got an exciting match here. We've got a time...
We'll both have eggs, home fries, and coffee, please.
How would you like your eggs?
Over easy.
I'll have mine scrambled, but not overcooked. Perfect.
Hey, that's John Smith and Alice Jude.
I didn't know they were in the semifinals.
Come on.
Well, there you have it. The Cincinnati Shells have just defeated the New York Yokes in one of the most exciting matches we've seen in a long time. The Shells will, of course, meet the Pittsburgh Poach next week for the World Championship at the beautiful LA Forum Cafe. And you'll be able to see it live right here on Superstation WDS9. For the mild world of sports, this is Gib Gifford. Back to you now, Don.
Man, I can't believe the Strokes in New York lost that game. There's
That's
no
what you get for betting a loser.
I'll meet you back here at 6 o'clock.
Hey, that'll be fine.
Good luck.
You too.
Hey, guess what? I got a job. Yeah. I start tonight.
Thank you.
tickets?
I can't find them. They're not in here.
Did you look in the glove compartment?
Not in there.
I can't believe you lost those damn things.
Well, I'm sorry.
Have you looked everywhere?
Everywhere.
When's the last time you saw them? I was really looking forward to go to this damn concert.
Well, maybe we can get in on our press pass.
Maybe we can get in.
Come on, it's almost
time.
John Smith, at the end of his proverbial rope, unaware that he is about to start a new life.
Alice! Oh, my God.
Father, after all, you were dead.
I'm here for my wedding.
And I suppose that I'm dead now, too.
You should be. That redhead had a big gun and a sure aim. But that's why I'm here. To give you a new chance at life. Because I know that you have the potential to become a great man. Now get out of here and make me proud of you. Hey, John.
Yes, Father?
You sang well tonight.
Thanks. Yeah.
No. Oh, God, no. 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 No, no, God, no, no. I'm sorry this had to happen to you. But better you than me.
That's why. Our love you since we started working together. And I thought, in my own dopey way, that you love me too.
Oh, Punchley, I do love you. I do.
Then why'd you run up with Smith?
I don't know. It was a spur of the moment decision. I was confused. What about that redhead?
Oh. There's two ships passing in the night. Besides, she's dead.
So's John.
What's stopping us?
Why didn't you tell me before?
Well, I was afraid of rejection, I guess.
Mr. Moneysworth, it's a pleasure to see you.
Cut the crap, broadside. I'm just here to tell you that the Star of Moscow diamond will be delivered to me momentarily.
Well, I'm glad for you. I'm glad you finally got what you wanted. But what do you want with me?
Just making sure that no one's left to tell the story.
Good man, you have the diamond. Give it to me.
Freeze!
Excuse me, sir. Can you tell me what is going on here?
No comment.
The winner of this matchup will, of course, meet the Pittsburgh Poached. I blew that one.
Yeah, start at the beginning of that one.
Gladys Ward, CIA. You're with the CIA?
Bullshit. Action.
I know. So long now. Do it again.
Hey, what'd he say?
He said he'd look at it.
Well, I guess.
guess that's the end of that line.
Also, I am here. Yeah, I screwed that up. I did that by accident.
Don't tell me, Interpol, right?
Up!
Gary, take your time when you grab him.
I owe you dinner.
I owe you a raise.
Aw, Bungie. Okay.
He is now in pursuit of the two, presumably for revenge.
Okay, cut. I liked it so much. Let's do it again. All right.
Cut. I don't think that that...
Oh, no. Pure TNT.
Let's see, the last really big story you had, you thought you uncovered the head of the Black Panthers doing business with the mayor.
Gee.
Okay. Oh my God.
I'm sorry. We'll handle one. I'm trying to frame this up. No. Straight up. Down.
What makes you say that, Chief?
You got a swastika in your hand.
Cut it.
Oh, yeah. Go! Yeah! Oh, yeah!
Take one.
Some of you go around that way, and come around this way, and some of you go this way, and go around that way, and wait for the action call!
What's that now? Sure.
Just a bit until...
Becky is like right about here. Because then what we'll do is we'll follow her.
That's pretty interesting.
It's my life.
Okay.
They told us love was simple. Told you it was free.
There they are, hey!
But they never tried to warn me.
Ah! I watch my world. Sounds like a seagull.
Up in flames.
I tell you, you can't get blood out of a rock. That's my motto.
Everybody needs a motto. It's a very swell motto.
Very swell. Do it again. Push the limits of our
dreams. Oh yeah, the book got cut with a 14-year-old.
I looked at this picture, and it really does look like she's going down on the Pope. It's funny.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
I'm still rolling, by the way.
So I felt that I was safe there. I had to lay my weapon down. Maybe we could start again.
Sydney Rosenblum, FBI. You're with the FBI?
That's right, sweetheart. As the sun
leads down. Now let's remember our lines here.
From an ember to a flame.
Young man, would you help me with my groceries?
Yes, ma'am.
Set the world on fire. Push the limits of our dreams to the
his problem.
Hey, you're going to have to stop and get your stuff out of here. They're here.
Just me, will ya?
I'm gonna set the world on fire. I wanna set the world on fire.
You know, since I've been with you, I've never been so happy.
Oh, yeah?
Well, give me their ETA and tell them to see me as soon as they get in.
Cut. Perfect.
Today is going to be a very special day.
Today is a very special day. Today everything will. Today I'm gonna bless you with my love. Today I'm gonna stress, that's not enough. So I'll search for words and feelings, a new way to describe my love, love, kind of love for you. The kind of love I'm singing of today is the kind of love that just won't wait. And if there is a certain way that I can make you feel okay, then you see that it's a very special day. You see that it's a very special day. You see that it's a very